For 25 years, students from across the Granite State have come together to match wits with their peers. The competition can be fierce, but so can the fun. Even so, the stakes are high because only one team can win the Granite State Challenge. Now, here's your host, Jim Janot.
And thank you very much. Hi again, everybody. Welcome to another game of Granite State Challenge, about halfway through our opening round of competition. As many of you know, we play 16 opening round games. This will be game 8 of our season, just about the halfway mark of this, by the way, our 25th anniversary. As we are celebrating our silver anniversary, it gives me a reason to remind you that this year we will be making available immediately after our broadcast, the broadcast on YouTube and a free video podcast on the iTunes Music Store. So all you have to do is check our website for more information. Let's give you more information on the teams playing in tonight's opening round game. First of all, we have the team from Bishop Brady High School with an enrollment of about 445 students, located in New Hampshire's Merrimack County.
Hi, I'm Janet Moffitt, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Tara Fitzgerald, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Johnny Bassett, and I'm a senior.
I'm Noah Mellon, and I'm a senior.
Joining us for the program as well, the coach of the team, James Miller, and his alternate tonight is Thomas Hayes, the Green Giants of Bishop Brady High School. So those are the Green Giants. Now let's introduce you to their opponents for tonight's opening round game. This is the team from Trinity High School, enrolling about 500 students and located in the state's Hillsborough County.
Hi, I'm James Stein, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Anna Kaladish, and I'm a sophomore.
Hi, I'm Brendan Newcutt, and I'm a sophomore.
Hi, I'm Ken Foote, and I'm a senior.
With us for the program this evening is the coach for the team. She is Mary Grace Ogorski, the Pioneers of Trinity High School. And we have one last introduction, and that's to let you know who our judges will be for this week's game. And this week, we welcome back Mary Riley Potter and Jim McShane. Thank them for their hard work each and every game. So we're ready to go right into our opening round, which is a 10-point toss-up round. And if you've been around, then you also know we have a bonus round and a 60-second round coming up. But right now, Bishop Brady and Trinity, these are 10-point toss-ups, and here we go. What name is given to the Swiss Alpine singing that requires the frequent changing?
Yodeling.
Cam of Trinity?
Yodeling.
Yodeling is right for your 10 points. Identify the person whose skull is found by the two clowns in Shakespeare's Hamlet while they are digging a grave. James of Trinity.
Yorick.
Yorick is also correct. Conservationists warned in 2000 that 25 species of apes, monkeys, lemurs, and others of that order are endangered. What word beginning with P names this group of animals, James of Trinity?
Primates.
Primates. We'll give your team another 10 points. Paper and pencil is in front of you if you think you might need it for this question. If the altitude of a triangle is twice the corresponding base and the area of the triangle is 169 square inches, what is the length of the altitude? We'll give you time on that. If the altitude of a triangle is twice the corresponding base and the area of the triangle is 169 square inches, tell us what is the length of the altitude. Johnny of Bishop Brady.
13.
Trinity. James.
26.
26 is right for the 10 points. All right, we'll give you a reminder again during our toss-ups. We don't talk to each other except in rounds 2 and 3. Let's go with another 10-point toss-up. What 555-foot marble obelisk was dedicated in Washington, D.C. in February 1885? Janet of Bishop Brady.
George Washington's obelisk.
Judges, will you take that? The Washington Monument specifically, but we're going to take it for the 10 points. Identify the four-letter word beginning with W, used in art to designate a thin, transparent layer of paint, usually watercolor, applied with an even, sweeping movement of the brush. Cam of Trinity.
Wash.
Wash is correct. Identify the Greek playwright who served the city of Athens in high office during both peace and war. He is the author of Ajax and Oedipus at Colonus. Janet of Brady.
Sophocles.
Sophocles will give you a team 10 points. Listen carefully now. The sum of the first four even natural numbers is how much larger than the sum of the first four natural numbers? The sum of the first four even natural numbers is how much larger than the sum of the first four natural numbers? James of Trinity.
Four.
Mr. Brady. It is 10. What structures in the heart ensure that blood flows in only one direction? Janet of Brady.
Valves.
Valves is correct. Now for 10 points, teams, we want you to tell us, who was the last U.S. president of the 19th century? It was William McKinley, and you might want to reset, judges. Here we go for 10 points. The recently found Egyptian sarcophagus was that of the god who, in Egyptian myth, was murdered by his brother Seth. James of Trinity.
Osiris.
Osiris is correct. Now give me the word starting with C-O, matching the following definition. A remark made in conversation. Cam of Trinity.
Compliment.
Bishop Brady. A remark made in conversation is a comment. More than 700 children in Japan were once hospitalized after watching anime or fast-paced graphic Japanese cartoons. Which disease or disorder makes a person, James of Trinity?
Epilepsy.
Epilepsy makes a person especially prone to reactions to strobe lights. Well done. Here we go for 10 points. He stole a fortune in gold and silver, burned towns in St. Gallen, killed Spanish colonists, was a prisoner in England. Janet of Bishop Brady.
Francis.
I can repeat it for Trinity. He stole a fortune in gold and silver, burned towns in St. Gallen, killed Spanish colonists, was a prisoner in England on charge of piracy, but nothing came of it. Who was this Englishman whom Charles II knighted and made governor of Jamaica? His name was Sir Henry Morgan. For 10 points, teams, at an exhibition of Jacob Epstein's sculpture, you could expect to see his depiction of the biblical Jacob wrestling with what figure? Janet of Bishop Brady.
God.
I can repeat it for Trinity, but I won't, James.
The devil.
It is the angel whom he fought in a dream. What is the largest prime number that can be rolled with a pair of dice? James of Trinity.
11.
11 is correct. During a nosebleed, blood issues from what kind of vessels? James of Trinity.
Capillaries.
Capillaries is correct. Just under a minute to play in our opening round. In 1846, General Zachary Taylor was ordered to advance south from the Nueces River to positions on the bank of what other river? Janet of Brady.
Mississippi.
Trinity. Anna.
Potomac.
It is the Rio Grande. Which college, founded by a well-known brewer, is located at Poughkeepsie, a city on the Hudson River? The college is Vassar College. And there's the sound ending our opening round. Well, a good start for Trinity as they get the early lead here in round number one by a score of 90-30. All right, before we go into our second round, which is our bonus round, we once again welcome back Lori Warren of this week. She's filling in for Tim Estilos. She was talking to the two teams prior to the program. Let's find out what they had to say when she met up with the team from Bishop Brady High School.
Hi, I'm outside with Bishop Brady High School. They are in Concord, and they are the Giants. Now, first we have Janet. All of them are seniors. We'll just get that clear right away. She's a captain of the team, and one of your interests is travel. Now, tell us where you've been.
I've been to England, Scotland, Austria, Germany, Hungary, Czech Republic, Slovakia, Canada, Spain, Italy, and France.
And Austria.
Yeah, I said Austria.
We obviously get some answers beforehand, so that's some crazy travel. Now, for someone so young, you're very well traveled.
Oh, thank you, yeah.
And are you planning on continuing that for many, many years?
Oh, yes. My family is planning a trip to Greece soon.
Oh,
so
wow. That should be so much fun. And this is Noah. He's a senior from Hillsboro. Now, you play hockey, right?
Yes. I play forward.
You play forward.
For Bishop Brady.
And how did Bishop Brady do last year?
Last year we went to the finals and we lost in a real close game. But this year, hope to
do better.
Okay, and there's no need to mention the team that won because, you know, they're not here and you are. Now, are you planning on trying to play in college, too?
Either club or intramurals, but probably not varsity.
You might rethink that because I think you're probably pretty good at it.
Thank you.
Okay, and this is Johnny now. Johnny, you play the bagpipes competitively, so tell us about some of the experiences that you've had with that.
Well, I go to competitions all over the East Coast. I've gone down as far as New Jersey, and I've gone up to Montreal and Maxville in Canada. Mm-hmm. Actually, this past weekend, I was up in Lincoln at Loon Mountain at the New Hampshire Highland Games.
Oh, yeah.
So that was a lot of fun. Get to see all my friends.
Now, how did you learn how to play?
It's kind of a corny story, but my fourth grade teacher used to come in on our birthdays and play happy birthday for us, and so I thought that was kind of cool.
Oh,
so it just went from there, I guess.
Yeah, and it's a very, really cool hobby. And this is Tara. She's a senior from Concord, and you're hoping to go to the Coast Guard Academy, aren't you?
Yeah, I really like it. So I went for a summer program, and it was a lot of fun.
Now,
so.
Where is it?
It's in New London, Connecticut.
Okay. And how do you get to go?
What do you mean?
Well, do you have to get appointed, like in the other academies?
It's just like a normal college. Like, you just apply, like, essays and teacher recommendations. Mm-hmm. And you have to pass, like, a fitness exam. Other than that, you're all set.
Okay, and then you can go save lives. That's excellent. Well, this is our team, Bishop Brady. They are going back into the studio. Over to you, Jim.
All right, thank you very much, Laurie, and we welcome the team from Bishop Brady High School. Right now, trailing after round number one, we got the big bonus round coming up, a chance to get right back into the hunt. In this round, we ask 10-point toss-up questions, get the toss-up correctly, and that team has a chance at additional bonus points. So here is your 10-point toss-up, teams. The product of two consecutive negative integers is 6. What's the larger of the two? We have Noah, Bishop Brady.
-2.
-2 is correct for your 10 points. So we'll go over to Bishop Brady. Janet, you're the team captain. You speak for them. Right now, you can ask them which category you would like. Scrambled, GEGS, biology breakdown, or papal puzzlement? Scrambled, GEGS, biology breakdown, or papal puzzlement?
Papal puzzlement.
Let's
please.
Go with the papal puzzlement. And again, Janet, you can talk to everybody, but I do take your answer for the team. 5 points apiece. Identify each of the following concerning the Pope. Word used to describe the Pope as incapable of error in defining doctrines of faith and morals.
Infallibility doctrine.
We'll take that. Infallible is really what we're looking for. Council called by the Pope to consider the worldwide Christian church, especially in regard to unity.
Ecumenical Council
will take.
Sorry.
Hill that was the site of Roman Emperor Nero's public gardens and circus, where, according to tradition, the first Pope, St. Peter, was crucified.
Could you repeat that, please?
It is the hill that was the site of the Roman Emperor Nero's public gardens, where St. Peter was crucified.
Capitoline Hill?
It is Vatican Hill. 10 out of 15, though, on the bonus, and we go with another 10-point toss-up. What is the name of the river and bay that separates the state of Delaware from southern New Jersey? Janet or Bishop Brady? Trinity? James?
The Hudson Bay?
It is the Delaware Bay. Name the composer of this Yuletide classic, Amahl and the Night Visitors. The composer was Menotti. Of the following three choices, select the preferred word or phrase. I would have liked to go, to have gone, or to be going. Janet or Bishop Brady?
I would like to go.
To go is correct for the 10 points. So we'll go back to Brady for scrambled GEGS, biology breakdown, or USC. The scrambled, the biology breakdown, or USC.
Biology.
Let's go with the biology breakdown. Here we go for 5 points apiece. Identify each of the following concerning biology. Number of chromosomes humans typically have.
46.
Correct. Abrupt change in the genotype of an organism that cannot be accounted for by the normal laws of genetics.
Mutation.
Correct. Offspring of genetically different parents who have two contrasting genes for the same trait.
Heterogeneous?
It is hybrid. 10 out of 15, once again, though, on the bonus as we go with the 10-point toss-up. Name the set of three subatomic particles transmitting the weak interaction or force. Janet of Brady.
Proton, electron, and neutron.
Trinity? is called Weak Bosons. Identify the Asian country whose former leader Suharto was absent from the start of his 2000 trial on corruption because of illness. Bishop Brady, Janet.
Japan.
I can repeat it for Trinity. Identify the Asian country whose former leader Suharto was absent from the start of his 2000 trial on corruption because of illness. It consists of an archipelago of about 13,500 islands along the equator. James?
Indonesia.
Indonesia is correct. So let's go over to Trinity. James, you can look at your teammates and choose from scrambled, G-E-G-S, U-S-C, or phraseology.
Scrambled.
G-E-G-S.
G-E-G-S.
Unscramble these letters to form English words. You might want to use paper in front of you. We'll give you a few seconds for each one. Unscramble these letters to form English words. Plurals and proper nouns are not allowed. D-E-L-L-A. Unscramble it and give me a word.
What? Lead.
Lead.
No, it is ladle. C-L-U-N-E. C-L-U-N-E.
Uncle.
Correct. M-I-I-D-O. M-I-I-D-O.
Idiom.
Is correct. 10 out of 15 on the bonus. And there's the sound ending our round. Well, things tightened up a little bit in round number two as Bishop Brady picked up some ground. This game's still wide open after two with Trinity leading 110 to 70. All right, let's call on Lori once again. This time she's talking with the team from Trinity High School.
And we're here with Trinity High School. They are from Manchester. Actually, the school is located in Manchester. They're from all different places. They are the Pioneers. And first, we're going to be talking to our team captain, James. Now, you're a senior from Hooksett.
Yes.
And your activities are just crazy. You're all over the place. You've got tennis, chorus, drama, math team. Pick a favorite, and why would that be your favorite?
I'd have to say drama is my favorite, just because it's a lot of fun, and the people who do it are just really great. I just really enjoy it, you know? It's a fun
that's
time
good.
Performing.
Is it dramatic?
Oh, very.
I would think so. Next, we have Anna. She's a sophomore from Wilton. Now, being a sophomore on the team is crazy.
Yeah, it was pretty exciting.
Yeah, no, you must be very, very smart. And you also are very accomplished. You play piano. So what would be some of your favorite composers or types of music?
My favorite composer is definitely Tchaikovsky. I've never found a piece I haven't liked. And I'm interested in classical and Baroque music.
Okay. All right, so that's very cool. So are you planning on pursuing that in college?
No, I just really like to play at my own time.
Okay. All right, that's a great hobby to have. And this is Brendan. He's also a sophomore, so we are loaded up with sophomores on this team. Now, you're a Boy Scout. What rank are you?
I'm a Life Scout, currently working on Eagle.
And that is quite an accomplishment. And you're also keeping up a family tradition by being here.
Yeah, my brother was on the team of the class of 98 at Trinity.
And how did his team do?
Pretty well.
But when you win the whole entire thing, then you get to rub it in his face, right?
Yep.
That'll be good. And lastly, we've got Cameron. He's a senior from Bedford. And, you know, we were wondering, Cameron, have you narrowed down your choices for college yet?
College is stressful, but I'm looking at McGill and Colgate are the two I'm looking at right now.
Okay, and they would seem like they're good hockey schools. Do you play?
All the time.
Okay. Are you on the team?
For Trinity, yes.
Mm-hmm. How'd you do last year?
Not too great.
It's always this year, right? Well, good luck with that, and good luck in the game. We've got to go back to the studio, and over to you, Jim.
And there they are. They are the Pioneers of Trinity High School. Well, Trinity got the lead at the end of the first period, lost a little bit of that lead in the second, and now we head into our third round, and we got a 60-second round. Each team will be fighting for as much as 110 points. We ask them 10 questions in 1 minute. We'll give them 10 points for every correct answer, a bonus of 10 should they get them all right in under a minute. So as we said, 110 points up for grabs. The team that trails does choose the category first, so Bishop Brady, you can choose from potpourri, idioms around the house, horse sense. Potpourri, idioms around the house, horse sense.
Idioms, please.
All right, let's go with the idioms. And Janet, you speak to your teammates, but I take your answer for the team. Complete the following idioms. Start the clock. To jump from the blank into the fire, meaning to escape from one bad situation only to become
frying pan?
Correct. Blank potato, designating a person who does little but watch TV.
Couch.
Correct. Strike while the blank is hot, meaning to take advantage.
Iron.
Correct. To be a wet blank, meaning to
blanket.
Correct. On pins and blank, meaning to be in a
state.
Correct. In the blank, meaning to be in disfavor.
Doghouse.
Correct. Behind closed blank, meaning
doors.
Correct. Turn the blank back, meaning to return to an earlier period.
Clock.
Correct. To make one's blank and lie in it, meaning to be responsible for what
bed.
You have done. Correct. Security blank, designating an object that one holds onto for psychological assurance.
Blanket.
That sounds like 10 out of 10 on those idioms around the house. We're going to give you 110 points for your effort in your 60-second round. Very well done for Bishop Brady. So now we'll go over to Trinity, see if they can make up some of that ground with potpourri or horse sense. Potpourri or horse sense.
We'll take potpourri.
All right, James, and you talk to everybody. I take your answer for the team's answer. We just want you to identify each of the following. Start the clock. Term beginning with I, used to describe a disease transmitted among people.
Infectious.
Correct. Name of one of the two coon hounds and where the red fern grows.
Pass.
Highest mountain in Africa.
Kilimanjaro.
Correct. Man who became Chancellor of West Germany in October 1982.
Adolf Hitler.
Helmut Kohl. City famous for its western wall, originally part of the Jews' temple during biblical times.
Jerusalem.
Correct. Bravest of the Knights of the Round Table, who was also the lover.
Lancelot.
Correct. King and queen, who financially backed Christopher Columbus's voyages.
Ferdinand and Isabel.
Correct. New Zealand bird that cannot fly.
Kiwi.
Correct. Rock fragment that Champollion used to decipher the Egyptian system of writing.
Rosetta Stone.
Correct. Shallow body of water separated from the open sea by sandbars or coral reefs.
Gettle Pond.
It is a lagoon, but you did pretty well. 7 out of 10 on their 60-second round. Very well done in that category, but look what we have here as we head into the fourth and final round. All tied up, 180 to 180 in a tremendously played game so far. Might mention no more talking to each other teams. We have 10-point toss-ups the rest of the way. The winner to our second round. Good luck. Here we go. The British puppets Wallace and Gromit were returned to their owner after being left in a taxi. What phrase borrowed from a biblical parable about a foreigner who helped a robbery victim was used to describe the taxi driver, Janitor Brady?
Samaritan.
The Good Samaritan is correct. Does serious mean the opposite of giddy, mistaken, or careless? James of Trinity.
Giddy.
Correct. What biome covers just 6% of the Earth's surface but contains half of the world's species? Johnny of Bishop Brady.
Rainforest.
Judges, you'll take that. Tropical rainforest is correct. It's now heavily promoting its Gamboa Rainforest Resort in the Sobirania National Park, competing for ecotourism dollars with neighboring Costa Rica. What is this Central American country, much of whose preserves were under U.S. control until late 1999? Janet of Bishop Brady.
Panama.
Panama is correct. Identify the annual international piano competition won in 1997 by American John Nakamatsu. It is the Van Cliburn International Competition. All right, we have 2 minutes to play in our game. I'll give you a key word followed by three words, and you identify the one that means the same or has the closest meaning to the key word. The key word is confront. The other words are face, amaze, abash. James of Trinity.
Face.
Face is correct. This three-syllable word refers to where an organism lives. Give me this term used in ecology, James.
Habitat.
Habitat is correct. By what name is the President's Commission on the Assassination of President Kennedy often known, a name derived from its chairman, the Chief Justice of the Supreme Court? It is the Warren Commission. Saying space exploration is as essential as electricity, which country sent a taikonaut into space in 2003, becoming the third country, Brandon of Trinity?
China.
China is correct. Of Thomas Gray, Lord Byron, and Thomas Chatterton, which English poet poisoned himself? Janet of Brady.
Chatterton.
Chatterton is correct. Just under a minute to go in our game. Identify the term designating the universe as a finite space that will eventually stop expanding and recollapse onto itself. James of Trinity.
The Big Crunch Theory.
Bishop Brady.
Big Bang Theory.
But it is closed universe. Skip the next one, judges. In what year did the Supreme Court issue the Miranda ruling? It was 1966, and we go on with another 10 pointers. Skip the next one, judges. Spell the name of the Canadian territory that is a homophone for Connecticut's nickname, Yukon. Janet or Bishop Brady?
Y-U-K-O-N.
That is correct for 10 points. Which Nebraska congressman ran unsuccessfully for the presidency in 1896, 1900, and 1908? Cam of Trinity?
Clay.
Bishop Brady, it's not necessary. William Jennings Bryan is the answer. Hey, look at this. They made the comeback, and we had a tremendous game tonight. Bishop Brady pulling out a 230-220 win. Outstanding opening round game. Both teams played extremely well, and it was a lot of fun to participate in. We hope it was a lot of fun for you folks at home to watch as well. Well, we're going to do it all over again next week as we have two more teams ready to do battle, they being Calvary Christian High School and Groveton High School. Great game tonight. Hope you enjoyed it. See you in 1 week. Good night, everybody.